And with me, conservative columnist and author of Never Trust a Liberal Over Three, Ann Coulter. All right, Ann, where does it all end?
Well, it's already pretty bad. I mean, it's not like we're at the top of the slippery slope. We're already at the bottom. I think the three biggest issues of alarming unconstitutional behavior is Obama's disregard of the Obamacare law, disregard of immigration laws, and disregard of the drug laws. Look, we have a constitution that specifically gives to the legislative branch, weirdly enough called the legislative branch, the right to write legislation, and it's carefully calibrated. You know, you have two senators from each state, and there are 6 years, and congressmen, they are more representative of the people,
and the
two bodies work together.
Of government, three equal branches.
Right, and consider, I mean, different branches have different roles. In terms of writing legislation, the president's role is quite clearly laid out, as he sort of indicates, but then ignores, with his pen, with his veto pen. That is his role, and he has a phone. He can call congressmen, he can call senators and say, this is what I'd like in the law. But other than that, he has no role in writing legislation. He is vetoing legislation by refusing to enforce it. Mm-hmm. The Constitution demands that the president of the United States take care that the laws be faithfully executed. He has simply taken it upon himself to rewrite Obamacare, to rewrite immigration laws, you indicated with the Dreamers thing, to rewrite drug laws. Now we're not in Colorado and Washington. Oh, sure, just legalize drugs that the federal government, that Congress has written and made illegal. This is the bottom of the slippery slope, and I think he would be impeached if he weren't America's first black president.
You know, a couple of thoughts, Ann. I mean, number one, Obamacare was a law that he wrote that he keeps changing, even though it said it shall, you know, start on a particular date. There's no ambiguity in the word shall and in the date, but he even changed his own law. But, Ann, you know, so many people will say, well, you know, other presidents have signed executive orders. What, you know, this president is entitled to do and sign however many orders he wants. Is there a difference?
No. Yes, thank you for asking that. It's been driving me crazy hearing these liberals and even conservatives, you know, count up the number of executive orders. No, of course a president can issue executive orders in order to regulate the executive branch. Probably 99% of executive orders are of no interest to anyone. It, you know, has to do with what kind of typewriters the secretaries within the executive branch use. Those executive orders are irrelevant. When your executive order is rewriting legislation, that is what violates the Constitution. And I'd also say, I mean, it's ironic and it's worth needling him over it, but it doesn't matter who signed the law. It doesn't matter if you like the law. Ask Andrew Johnson. It doesn't matter if the law is unconstitutional. If that's what the law is, the president is required to take care that it be faithfully executed. And Obama is just coming up with all new laws. It really is a shocking abuse of power.
So, Ann, what can people do? What can be done if this really is so beyond what every other president does in terms of executive orders? And by the way, he's a lawyer. He alleges he was a constitutional professor, but he's a lawyer. He knows the law. I mean, every lawyer I know understands that this is not the way a president is supposed to act. So what can you do?
Yes. Well, I mean, any honest liberal lawyer or any honest liberal who's read the Constitution will tell you this is completely beyond the purview, the powers of the president. I mean, technically, yeah, the constitutional response is impeachment. I suppose there may be something that Congress could do with the purse, but not with the Senate in Democrat hands. And I mean, unfortunately, and I hate to say this, the Constitution isn't supposed to be overruled by political correctness, but I wasn't joking at the beginning. The first black president is not going to be impeached. So let's just hope the next president is at least subjected to the threat of impeachment so that he won't take over the legislature's powers.
And let's just hope that 2016 comes sooner than it really will be coming. Ann Coulter, thanks so much for being with us tonight.